Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to F123 Breaking Point 2 for the start of the 2023 season. Now, last episode, we won the F2 championship with Calimare, which means she cannot return to Formula 2. So, what is she going to do? And when will we see her again? Now, at the end of last episode, we saw Casper Ackerman being announced as Connor Sport's new team principal, as Andrea O'Connor is stepping out of that role but will still be at the helm as the team owner but not as the team principal anymore. So, Casper Ackerman is the new team principal, and we also saw that Devin was not too pleased to see Casper again. So, what will that bring? Aiden Jackson said he at first was trying to get out of Connor Sport, but apparently has decided to stay. So, what will that bring? Let's head into 2023. So, it would seem. Oh, who's calling? Devin, though. Oh, we're Devin.
Devin, how's business?
Good as ever. I'm firing. How's racing?
Oh, you know, ducking and driving.
But,
of course, I've double checked these strategy changes. I'm just going over my notes now. Everything's covered just like always. They won't see me.
Just remember, we've put a lot on the line this season.
Yeah, I know.
Devin, I'm serious. You're carrying this team a bit together.
Yeah, well, you keep signing these second-rate drivers. I can't do all the work.
Just remember where we'd be. Where you'd be if this were all to go belly up.
Trust me, Devin. You've got nothing to worry about.
Devin.
Wow. Look at that. So now we are driving as Devin Butler. And he's definitely fond of himself. He's got a lot of merchandising of himself. We got a stand-up standee and then a box of something of his. So, let's head into the Bahrain Grand Prix. Race day. So will this be a full Grand Prix? With his confidence high, Devin Butler looks set to start the new season strong at the Bahrain Grand Prix. Loading. Here we go. Please wait. Here we go.
Welcome to the Bahrain International Circuit. At any moment now, our drivers will take to the track and the Bahrain Grand Prix can begin. We'll be racing around 3.36 miles of the magnificent Bahrain International Circuit today. Keep an eye out for drivers locking the front left down into the tricky braking zone of Turn 10. So with the race not far away from starting, here's what today's grid rundown looks like. World champion Max Verstappen starts from pole position, and Charles Leclerc in P2. Considering the rest of the grid, we have Fernando Alonso, Russell, Perez, Hamilton, Sainz, Stroll, Ocon, 5 red lights to go out then. Let's see who can prevail today. 2023 Bahrain. We're about to get going and I hope you've enjoyed the build-up just as much as we have. The teams are ready on the grid, ready in the garages too, but in the commentary box alongside me. You're ready, Alex?
Of course I'm ready, Crofty. New season, new challenges for all of them out there, drivers and teams. I love this part of the Crofty. This is where it really kicks off. And you get to showcase all that hard work you've done through the winter months. Does it pay off?
Yeah, that's the question, isn't it? What does the 2023 season have in store for us? About to find out.
Okay, Devon, it's a brand new season, you know that, so let's start it as we mean to go on, okay? Okay? Let's get out of there, come on.
Let's do this. No idea why they're having us start on No way am I starting on the mediums. Finish in the top five, okay. Here we go, for 14 laps. Lights out and away we go. This new Countersport car looking nice. Already up into P8 now. So driving as Devin Butler, I am very, very I badly want to just slam into the barrier, but I'm going to hold off on it, and we're going to go for this P5 finish. Up on Fernando Alonso. Took a little peek down the inside into the final corner. Didn't stick with it. Go down the main straight. Take the racing line. And squeeze Alonso to tighten his line. And we do make it up into P6. Half looked on Sergio Perez into turn 4. Thought better of it. However, emulating the same move that Fernando Alonso made on Lewis Hamilton, we overtake Sergio Perez on the inside of turn 9 and turn 10. What a move. So the bonus objective is to finish in the top 3 with the fastest lap. Purple First Sector. Now we'll have DRS on Charles Leclerc, who also has DRS on Lewis Hamilton in front. In the green second sector, here we come on Leclerc. Force him to tighten up his own racing line and move up into P4 behind the two Mercedes. Now the fastest lap. The two Mercedes battling each other. To start the next lap and into turn four, the rundown to turn four, we're able to overtake both of them up into P2 now. Can we possibly chase after Max Verstappen? Within DRS of the reigning world champion, closing to the gearbox of that Red Bull. As we start lap 5, DRS on Verstappen, not gonna be enough to close up all the way to Verstappen, but in down turn towards the run to turn 4, down the inside, half-hearted look, back out of it, just ever so slightly. Now, have to once again go chasing after Verstappen. Have Hamilton coming up behind us. So the 7-time champ lurking in the background. Once again, down the main straight, DRS much closer to Verstappen this time. He tries to go defensive to the inside. We're going to stick to the racing line. It's Verstappen who has DRS down towards turn 4, but with the slipstream and battery usage, we're going to be able to squeeze past Verstappen out of the corner. Here comes Verstappen again. Going to squeeze him out. I believe he will not have DRS, but that will mean that he is exposed to Lewis Hamilton. As we start lap 7, let's head to the pits. Five-second time penalty, speeding in the pit lane. Yeah, that's not good. Here we go. Still want to win this race, then we're going to bridge a 5-second gap to Verstappen. Let's Stroll in front of us. He's not pitted yet. We're going to make easy work with him with our fresh mediums. Try and pull away from Verstappen. Push as quick as we can to hopefully bridge a 5-second gap. On the soft tire, we were faster than Verstappen at the start of the stint, but coming to the end of the stint, it was actually Verstappen who had the better pace. So, who will have the better pace on the mediums? So we re-overtake Russell and Perez in the pits. The gap, 4.4 seconds to Verstappen. And growing. We need a 5-second gap to be able to hold on to this win. In 6 laps. Gap now at 5.3 seconds. That's where we need it to be. Now, just need to finish the race. To be honest, I wish the race would end on this lap. Six seconds the gap now to Verstappen. Think we are the quicker car on the mediums. Mark, shut the fuck up. On to lap 10 now. Well, I'm going to let you guys do. So I'm gonna let you guys skip to the end or the next part of action. Down this back straight, heading to the final lap of this 2023 Formula One Bahrain Grand Prix. Despite the penalty, we have a 10-second gap over Mr. Verstappen. Looking to take Hunter Sports' first race win in the first race of the 2023 season. We already scored a podium back in Suzuka with Aiden Jackson in the 2022 season. Looking to take the first win with Devin Butler in 2023. Few corners left to go to take the win here in Bahrain. It may be with Devin Butler, but a win is still a win, in my opinion. Checkered flag, we win the Bahrain Grand Prix. Devin Butler and Connor Sport on top here in the Bahrain Grand Prix. What a result for Connor Sport.
Thank you.
Well. Post race of Chapter 7, the Bahrain Grand Prix. Let's see how this goes. Are we going to get a message from our dear old father? What did happen with Devin? Well, we'll find that out in this next episode, hopefully. But for now, that is the end of Chapter 7 and the end of Episode number 6. So guys, if you have enjoyed this one, don't forget to like, subscribe, hit that little bell, get notified whenever I post new videos, and I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye.